Welcome to Soaping 101. This week, we're creating an ultra-cleansing soap bar designed to clean pores and help diminish the return of blemishes. There are several key ingredients in this recipe. One is a bit of moisture to counteract the effect of the cleansing agents. And olive oil is one such moisturizer. The second element is egg whites. I'm using a farm fresh egg. The white of the egg contains lysozyme, which is an enzyme that combats bacteria. I'm including aloe vera gel, fresh from the leaf. Aloe contains moisture. It can help speed up wound healing. This is pure raw honey from my local beekeeper. Honey has antibacterial and anti-inflammatory properties. It's also a humectant, drawing moisture from the air to the skin. We'll mix these ingredients together. I am including a small amount of citric acid to aid in creating a milder bar and one that foams well in both hard and soft water. Blemish-prone skin needs deep cleaning, but it also needs moisture replenishment. This coconut milk will hydrate without clogging pores. Stir to incorporate all the ingredients, but not so much that you turn your eggs into meringue. We can move on to our lye water. I have lessened the amount of water by 2 ounces and replaced it with coconut milk, as you saw in the previous clip. Into the lye water, I'm adding activated charcoal, since it's a water-soluble product. In the finished soap, activated charcoal aids in drawing oil and dirt from pores. Mix slowly so that it does not become airborne and make a mess. We are almost ready to mix the soap. Two last ingredients. One is tea tree oil. You either love or hate the smell, but the components of tea tree oil aid in killing bacteria with little irritation. The second ingredient is baking soda. Baking soda acts as an extremely mild exfoliant, breaking up and removing dead skin cells. The base of our soap is coconut oil, which you see here. It lends ultra-cleansing properties to the soap. As we add our black lye water to the coconut oil, we need to keep in mind that 10% of our soap oils, the olive, and 42% of our liquid from the lye solution, the coconut milk, has yet to be added. Do not expect this to trace properly, because it may not. We are looking for emulsification at this stage. I'm working at room temperature, about 75 degrees Fahrenheit, but saponification can create an exothermic reaction and heat up our soap. We want to make sure our egg does not become scrambled or cooked, but rather incorporated with the lye. We do this by tempering it slowly. Add a little, mix, and repeat. We can now add the egg mixture to the main pot and blend until it reaches trace. It should do so easily, as all of our ingredients are now included as one. If you want to see what we're up to next, or see sneak peeks of upcoming projects, be sure to follow Soaping 101 on Instagram. I've listed the complete recipe to this soap in the description box below. After molding, I will put this soap in my refrigerator overnight. Again, we want to keep the eggs as cool as possible during saponification. Removing the bars from this mold is a breeze. And here we have 6 uniform soaps designed to clean blemish-prone skin. Well, that's it for this week. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see y'all next time.